وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ.
تقال العثار العظام به ويرد الهوى ككبش ذبيح بذكر الإله.
The situation of him, his food is haram, his drink is haram, his clothing is haram, فَأَنَّا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. So how will Allah accept his dua? He has everything in him for his dua to be accepted, but there are barriers, there are things here and here and here that are stopping his dua from being accepted. And that is the case for many of us. Yes, you continue making dua, but you always fear that maybe I have this mani, this thing here that is stopping my dua being accepted. Maybe I need to look at myself. Is my sustenance pure? Am I asking for a good thing? Do I know where every single riyal or every single pound that I spend goes? I might have told you this story before, but I'll tell you again at the risk of repeating myself. I met a very, very interesting man, an elderly man in Makkah. And he lived in a very, very, very poor shelter. He lived in a simple hut in the hills with just a corrugated iron roof. And he didn't have a working AC, or his AC was very broken. And he just had a concrete sort of floor with a little bit of a rug over it. And he just slept on the floor. Wallahi, in my life, I have never seen anybody happier. I have never seen anyone with so much self-contentment. So much so that I said to him, Uncle, tell me something. Tell me, why is it that you live like this? And I see you are a person who is so content. He said, son, listen to me. He said, I do not earn a single riyal except that I know where it comes from and where I spend it. And this is something, honestly, you can find from the stories of the Salaf and the stories of the people today. And this is something I experienced. If you know where your income comes from, and you know what you spend it, every single penny, and you leave anything that has doubt in it, and you just give it away, or you return it back to the person, then wallah, you will see your dua being answered in front of you, to the point where you will feel, I have never made dua except that Allah has answered it. So many of us, our sustenance is the reason why our dua is blocked. And it's not just that, oh, I don't earn from haram. How many times do we earn money that we don't deserve? We go to work and we talk instead. We go to work and we do other things that we're not supposed to do. We take a long break that we shouldn't have, and we take the money for it anyway. This has an element of haram in it, an element of ghish, of cheating in it. And you know, subhanAllah, many times it's not just about where you earn, but also how you spend.
ليت اليوم تفهمني وتفهم خاطري ورحل تكلم والشجرة مني سيف الهم تراه استل سيف الهم تراه استل.